Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Today we are starting Star Wars Jedi Knight Jedi Academy from 2003, but I could be wrong about that. But anyway, game about 20 years old. Really, really good lightsaber combat. Yeah, I mean, one of my all-time favorite games, guys, so I'm excited to get to do a playthrough for you guys, and we are doing this on the enhanced mod, which really cleans up the old graphics and brings them into, you know, I guess they're technically from the 21st century, but brings them into the 21st century, so to speak, and really makes the game look fresher. And adds a lot of new content, which I'll show you guys here while we're creating the character. We are going to start a new game on Jedi Knight difficulty. And we're going to have Jaden be the version of Jaden that is a human that looks the most like me. But look at all these other heads. You got, you know, Obi-Wan, Anakin, you know, Lando, Ben, old Ben, Rosh. Plenty of options for what you want your character to look like, but I'm gonna go with Old Faithful, the version of Jaden, the human version of Jaden that looks the most like me, and we're gonna change his clothes throughout because we got plenty of clothing options. So we're gonna start out with legs for one, not just weird in motion. You know, it is a mod. It is not perfect, but yeah, we're gonna start out like this and keep the white, black, and gray color scheme. And this is what Jaden's gonna look like before he's a Jedi. And then we'll customize the lightsaber. Plenty of options here, you know. Just to show you a few, there's the Ahsoka and Rebels, Anakin's classic saber from Attack of the Clones, the iconic Anakin Skywalker lightsaber, you know, just skip down a few. You got Dooku in there. The dark saber, the Vader lightsaber, one of my favorites. But we're gonna get to the one that we're gonna actually have to choose one here. I didn't decide this in advance, so you could also customize a saber, and I'll do that later on in the story, but right now I'm just gonna choose one. And if you go all the way to the bottom, you get all the options from Jedi Academy originally. Qui-Gon Jinn saber. I had a toy one of those as a kid. Boss. Let's see. CC10. No, looks too clean. We're playing as a character that built one with no Jedi training. We don't want it to look too clean. Anakin Solo, the ancient Christ guard from Rebels. That looks too good still. The Darth Malak saber, maybe. Classic Darth Revan saber. That's what we're going to go with. We're going to go with the Galen from Force Unleashed 2. And we are going to go with blue. And, yeah. We're going to start the game. I'll show you a few more options, but I've decided on that one. Jedi Temple Guard. You know, Juhani. Mara Jade. George Lucas didn't create her. And then Yoda. And Yaddle. Build your own, and then here's the guitar, and then here's all the other ones from, you know, actually were from the game, created for the game, but we are gonna go with Galen Merrick, Starkiller from The Force Unleashed 2. Let's do it. Let's start the game, guys. A long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away. Star Wars. 10 years after the Battle of Endor, the Imperial Remnant continues to be driven back by the New Republic, forcing the Imperials to adopt increasingly desperate tactics in the ongoing struggle. I'll let it catch up to me. I'm used to having to struggle to catch these. Meanwhile, Jedi Master Luke Skywalker moves to restore the Jedi to their former place. Former place? As peacekeepers of the galaxy at his Jedi Academy on Yavin 4. Jaden Korr, a promising student from Coruscant, is en route to the Academy after achieving the impossible, creating a lightsaber without any formal Jedi training. Text crawl.
We'll be arriving at the Academy in just a few minutes.
All these different species you can.
That would be
as.
So great! Aren't you excited? We're going to be Jedi! Learning the ways of the Force, building a lightsaber. Ah, of course, you already have one. I'm gonna get one of those stupid training sabers and
I wouldn't worry about that.
I can't help it. I want to make a good impression.
You seem really nervous.
Aren't you? I mean, well, why would you be? You already have a lightsaber, so you're probably way ahead of me. I'm Rosh, by the way. What's your name?
Jaden.
So where'd you get that lightsaber?
Well, it's kind of a long story. I found myself on...
Hold on! Ah!
Academy to Yavin Runner 2. Do you copy?
Loud and clear. We made an emergency landing several clicks west of the Academy.
Is everyone all right?
I think so.
Good. We'll send a shuttle to pick you up. Can you lead the students to the nearby Masasi Temple?
Affirmative, Academy. We'll meet you there.
A thief. Alright, guys. Our shuttle.
Jaden, we can't get to you. Make your way to the temple. The shuttle will meet us there.
Jaden, hey! I'm stuck! Can you help?
Hold on, Rosh. I'm on my way.
Well, that escalated quickly.
Jaden, see if you can make your way around there. Maybe you can use your lightsaber to cut those trees down and make a bridge.
Our shuttle was shot down by a mysterious figure.
Maybe you can use your lightsaber to cut those trees down and make a bridge.
Shut up, Rosh. I'm talking. Our shuttle was shot down by a mysterious figure. We met with Rosh. We just saved him. There.
Thanks, Jaden. Let's get to the temple.
And now we're heading to the temple. By ourselves.
Whoa! Howlers!
Howlers. Watch out! Seems pretty close to himself. But yeah, we have to meet Ross. And our shuttle got shot down. And it looks like somebody is robbing the Jedi Temple as we speak, guys.
There must be a way to open this.
No problem.
See Ross open that with the Force.
Watch out!
And there's something you'll be seeing me do a lot, guys. The saber throw in this game is pretty overpowered and pretty satisfying, so you'll be seeing me do it a lot. I won't try to do a counter or anything, but
Oh!
If I kill three, then really cool for me when I was a kid was going under this water tank. The fact that I found this, which isn't even a secret area in the game, made me think I was the coolest kid on the planet. One of the things that they updated with this mod is they brought the, they made the smaller health and force bars, and they've also updated the crosshair. It looks a lot cleaner.
Hey, maybe you can use your saber to make another bridge. Great, let's go.
But, yeah. But I think this game's really cool, guys. Not as obscure as I used to think it was, but yeah.
Jean, get down! There's stormtroopers in the clearing. Maybe you should, check it out. You're the one with the lightsaber, after all.
This. Looks like we're finding ourselves in a bit of a lightsaber duel, but we make quick work of that guy cutting him in half. He's not Darth Maul. I don't think his hate's gonna preserve him long enough, and on to the temple.
What?
Huh? What? Who are you?
Kyle Katarn, at your service. Welcome to a day in the life of a Jedi.
What happened?
We were kind of hoping you could tell us.
I saw a huge flash of light and ran over to find you, just lying unconscious.
Do you recall anything?
I saw three people. One was holding some sort of scepter and it was glowing. That's all I can remember.
A scepter? That sounds bad.
Are you able to stand?
Yeah, I'm okay.
I sense a disturbance in the Force.
You always sense a disturbance in the Force. But yeah, I sense it too. It could just be residual dark side aura from this temple.
Perhaps. Kyle, why don't you...
Stay here and investigate? I'd love to. Why don't you take the kids back home now?
Be careful, Kyle. Everyone, follow me to the shuttle.
I think that... That was Luke Skywalker.
Yep.
I can't believe it.
The same one?
Did you recover Skywalker's records?
Yes. With all the Jedi in the jungle, it was almost too easy.
Excellent.
I'd like to welcome all our new students to the Jedi Academy. Here we will train you in the ways of the Force. You will learn to defend yourself with a lightsaber. You will also study diplomacy, history, and more. It has been the practice of the Jedi to assign each student to a master. However, since there are still so few of us, we will be assigning multiple students to one master. So, Routheron, you will be assigned to Master Horn.
I can't wait to begin my training.
Rosh Penin, you will be assigned to Master Katarn. Jaden Korr, you'll also work with Master Katarn. Now, let's begin with your first lessons, and may the Force be with you.
And there was nothing. But the area around the temple felt strange, like its dark side aura was... gone.
Troubling. But let's look into this later. Your students are ready to get started.
Master Katarn, it's an honor to be serving under you.
First off, just call me Kyle. Titles make my skin crawl. Secondly, you're not serving under me. I'm going to teach you, and you're going to learn. That's it.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to offend you.
Don't worry, Rosh, you didn't. I've been offended by professionals. Now, let's see what you two kids can do. Follow me to the training grounds.
All right, on to the training grounds, guys.
This is one of the many training grounds here at the Academy. I'm going to put you two in separate courses. When you're ready, Jaden, go through that door. Rosh, follow me.
I used to start off this mission by trying to kill Rosh or Kyle and trigger a battle, and if you either Kyle would kill you or you would succeed in killing Rosh, and you would immediately fail the mission.
This course will familiarize you with your core Force abilities. These are powers that every Force user has. As you progress in your training, you will learn new abilities. Both the light and dark sides will be open to you. Remember, abilities are not inherently good or evil. It's how you use them. Every Jedi is naturally stronger in different areas of the Force, and it will be up to you to decide what to focus on. All right, let's get started. In the next area, you'll find some training remotes. These will help you learn how to handle a lightsaber. Ready?
Ready!
Ready!
Remotes.
Here come the remotes.
Done!
Nice work, Rosh. You did well too, Jaden. Your lightsaber is an invaluable tool. Even when inactive, it can defuse a potentially volatile situation. Trust me on that. As you train, you'll learn additional fighting styles. Changing styles during combat can surprise your opponent, allowing you to gain the upper hand. From here on out, we'll talk via comlink in each area. Let's move on.
Okay, Jaden. You need to use the Force to jump across the ravine.
I can't.
It shouldn't be a problem.
Level 1 Force jump, go! Let's do it.
You'll have to use push to get out of here and into the next area.
Yep. Hey, Jaden! This should keep you busy till I finish the course.
Rosh always trying to make hard things harder for us, I suppose. Fight this training.
What took you so long, Jim?
Nothing.
You're sure?
It was nothing.
To get to the next area, you must pull a lever somewhere in the room. But you can't reach the lever with your hands. Remember to examine your environment carefully. When you're out on a mission, if you find a locked door, look for the guy in charge. He usually has a key. Solutions to problems aren't always obvious. Use your Force sense to see if you can find a way out of the room.
We don't need to pull that other one. I used to be so bad at this as a kid. It'd take me so many attempts.
Done. You'll need to move fast in this next area. You can use the Force to speed up both physically and mentally, allowing you more time to make decisions.
Is crouch bound to anything? No. vintage force powers set up. We're gonna change. Got anything for B? Bush is gonna be B. That's all there is to it. Also, they added a few extra force powers in this version. So, yeah. Wait for our force to fill up. I'm gonna try this. Almost.
So, did I win?
It wasn't a competition.
Dang right.
I'm sorry,
I'm not the one you should be apologizing to.
It's no big deal. You said yourself this wasn't a competition.
Hey, it was just a joke. I didn't think it would...
If that droid was set to Luke's training regimen, it would have killed Jaden. What were you thinking?
Jaden, I'm so sorry. I can't believe I... I mean, I wasn't trying...
Save it, Rosh.
Jaden, you have a right to be angry. But believe me when I say you don't want to feed that emotion.
I understand, Master Katarn. Apology accepted, Rosh.
Good, that's settled. And remember, it's Kyle?
Yes, Matt. Kyle.
Sure thing, Kyle.
Okay. You're both ready to start putting what you've learned to use. Let's see how you do in the real world.
Kyle, I did some research on that strange mark from the clothing we found at the temple. It is the symbol of Marka Ragnos. A Sith Lord that died almost 5,000 years ago.
5,000 years? Are you serious? Wait. Of course you're serious.
While you're out training your students, be on the lookout for information regarding a group affiliated with Ragnos.
Sure thing, Luke.
We receive countless requests for assistance from all over the galaxy. Since we believe in learning by doing at the Academy, students of all levels help with these requests. Since you're an initiate, however, Kyle will travel with you on most of your missions in order to instruct you and ensure your safety.
Cool. Alright, guys. That is going to be it for this episode of Jedi Knight Jedi Academy. There's a little bit to unpack there, but basically, we met everybody. We met Rosh. We met... Katarn, you know, the man who in the original canon stole the Death Star plans. We met Luke Skywalker, the pilot that killed the Death Star. Yeah, you know, we got to learn a little bit about everybody. Rosh is very competitive and wants to show how good he is. He's very ambitious. Kyle is Kyle. He doesn't like titles. He's not easily offended. Jaden gets really mad at Rosh, but then Kyle's like, hey, buddy. And Jaden pretty quickly forgives him. And that's all there is to it. We learned a little bit about this cult of Ragnos that's very mysterious. And, you know, we learned a couple things about Luke's new Jedi Order in that canon, which was, you know, at the Academy on Yavin 4, and was a lot different than we see in the later sequel trilogy. A lot cooler, I'd say. But, Luke was all about not making the same mistakes of the original Jedi Order, you know. He encouraged, you know, relationships and got married himself to a character that George Lucas didn't invent, by the way. And also, you know, he was all about, it's how you use the Force powers. It's not the Force powers themselves that are good or evil. But yeah. that's about all I got to say on that one. On the next episode, we are going to Tatooine to investigate some mercenary activity. If you guys liked what you saw, you know what to do. And I'll see you in the next one. Laters.